Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. In the previous update, I mentioned clustering a convergence of critical geometry. We had it on the 13th and 14th, and also on from the 17th to the 19th. These are the red and purple peaks, and when they converge, there is the potential of larger seismic activity. If we look at the SSGI graph, what actually happened, we see clustering of stronger earthquakes. This is a typical temporal clustering. It wasn't all that much, but it was an obvious seismic response on the 14th and 15th. And it actually peaked magnitude 6 in Ethiopia. And also on the 18th and 19th, we see some clustering there as well, peaking 5.7, again with the convergence of critical planetary geometry, the red and purple peaks. Again, when they converge, that's key. And I also mentioned the lunar peak on the 21st, and there was the potential here for a larger seismic activity from approximately the 20th to the 23rd. So far, that has not happened. But if you look at the next time frame, I added the two earthquakes that we actually had yesterday, a 5.6 and a 6.0, that was at Santa Cruz Islands and the Solomon Islands. And that is the seismic response that we actually had. It could be much larger, but it's only borderline 6. And what I see here, what is very apparent, is the absence in particular of the mid-6 magnitude earthquakes. So I did some calculations, and that's what you see here in the last 10, 11 years, 6.5 and 6.6 in particular. And if you look on the long yearly average, we see that it happens on average about 15.7 times per year. 6.5, 6.6, you know. And what we see is that in 2014, there were 27 of them, was very active. But in the last couple of years, it went down to 12, below average. And then in 2023, we had 16. That's pretty much the average. And then look at 2024. It also includes the first 2 months of 2025, and we only see 9. And this is actually what we have been observing in the last period, that we don't see these typical mid-6 magnitude earthquakes. If you look back at the SGI graph, the previous time frame, especially the geometry from the 17th to the 19th, I expected magnitude 6.5, approximately one or two maybe, but at least one, but it didn't happen. We do see a seismic response, but not the typical stronger earthquakes that is associated with that planetary geometry. The SGI graph algorithm is really focused on those stronger earthquakes. And we do see them, the higher 5, 6 magnitude, but not the mid 6. And that's really a tendency that we see here in throughout 2024 and early 2025. So we have some larger earthquakes, 7.6 recently in the Caribbean plate, but these mid-6 magnitude earthquakes, they are definitely below average. And I mentioned it before, the 7.8 and larger earthquakes, we have them 2-3 times a year on average. In the last 2 years, nothing. Magnitude 8 earthquakes on average, once a year. We haven't seen one in 3.5 years. So yes, there seems to be a decline of stronger earthquakes. And if we look at the mid-6 magnitude range, 6.5, 6.6, we see the same tendency here. So that's what I wanted you to know. The geometry is there, the seismic response is there, but just not the larger earthquakes as we normally anticipate them. Okay, these are the statistics. Very interesting, very important to observe. So back to the next time frame. We had these strong earthquakes yesterday, but nothing major. And if you look at this time frame, we see actually one convergence of planetary and lunar geometry, and that will be on the 28th, on the 28th of February and the 1st of March. Two lunar conjunctions, and that is Saturn and Neptune, and in particular, the red and purple peaks, Venus, Mercury, Saturn in a conjunction, a very tight convergence, in a very tight convergence with Sun, Mercury, Uranus, and then we have to pay attention. Because if Mercury and Venus are involved in planetary conjunctions like this, or critical planetary geometry in general, there is the potential for large seismic activity. And in this particular case, I would say the 2nd or 3rd of March, around the 3rd, but could be earlier, around the 2nd, there could be an obvious seismic response, the typical clustering of strong earthquakes, of course, but there's the potential of a larger earthquake as well. At this point, it's difficult to say how large. Like I said, the mid-6 magnitude earthquakes are below average currently. I'd say be on extra alert, especially on the 2nd and 3rd of March, around those days, because of that convergence of planetary lunar geometry. In the solar system, we see that geometry there perfectly. The planetary conjunction Sun, Mercury, and Uranus is the red line there, and also Venus, Mercury, and Saturn. And there's only a few hours in between. That's a really tight convergence, and we should anticipate larger seismic activity. And also the lunar geometry, these are the green lines, that's where Saturn and with Neptune, and it's also new moon, that's just before the convergence. And also we see quite some right angle geometry involving Mercury and Venus, and this all converges on the 28th of February and the 1st of March. So that is the only really critical geometry that we're going to have. But we also see here on the SGI graph on the 25th, that's tomorrow, Earth in a conjunction with Mercury and Saturn. There can be some seismic response there, and it could actually go into the 6th magnitude range, and it could be on the 26th or 27th. And of course, the Moon, Earth, and Mars conjunction on the 24th, there could also be some seismic response, typical higher 5 magnitude earthquakes. Slight possibility of a stronger seismic event. That's always the potential if we look at the lunar conjunctions with outer planets in general. That's what we have so far. Check out the latest anomalies, the latest updates on the website and also in our social media. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.